With the emergence of NFTs, DAOs, DeFi, and other decentralized applications, it's no question that Web3 is going to make a huge impact on how we interact with technology. But how? In this two-part series, crypto's leading experts weigh in on what they think the Web3 movement is about, where they see it heading, and what role zero knowledge will play in its development. But first, what is Web3?
You know, for me, it's about spreading the ethos of that early, you know, Bitcoin vibe.
You know, that was all about taking control back over your own money and having the freedom of choice between different financial systems, not being trapped into one.
Restoring individual sovereignty over your data and the way that you interact with the internet.
It brings the features of cryptocurrency natively into the internet. And a lot of those features are things that haven't really existed on the internet so far. Things around cryptographic privacy, things around ownership, things around like collectively making decisions.
Web3 really enables people to be in a much more level global playing field and all benefit from the same types of values and services and products.
Sounds amazing, but what's the catch?
As the internet does become a bigger and bigger part of our lives, and as the companies behind the internet and the tools they have at their disposal become more powerful, it's going to be super important that as users, we retain some power in that new dynamic that will show up.
And you can imagine, you know, that some of the most vulnerable and marginalized people who might actually stand to gain the most from crypto and sort of like all of the alternative financial rails that it introduces, you know, those folks may be some of the people who need privacy the most.
The way that the vast majority of people interact with what you would term as Web3 are through centralized intermediaries. And they also interact with applications that aren't really very good at respecting their privacy.
There are very different ways of interacting with Web3 apps in order to do so securely and consciously of, you know, what data you're providing to the general public, of how to maintain control and sole access to your wallet, to your systems.
We also do have a long way to go in terms of making these systems safe and secure.
We need a technology, a blockchain, a network technology that can be directly accessible by any individual, no matter, you know, whether they have an average smartphone or, you know, or if they're if they prefer to trust a company to be able to use that service.
This is the place where privacy preserving mechanisms become critical, and most of such privacy preserving mechanisms are going to have zero knowledge properties.
So, how can zero knowledge improve Web3?
With zero knowledge proofs, you can actually have all the benefits of operating in a blockchain context without sacrificing user privacy. And so being able to actually use sensitive information without revealing it to the world at large.
You know, think about logging into your own bank account, whether those are analog applications. Think about, again, keeping in the financial sphere. Think about using cash. You know, there are always privacy features of these things, and there are certain expectations that we have around being able to control who gets to see what about our data.
Because you don't necessarily want all of your information publicly accessible, but it might be really nice to be able to attest that, like, certain qualities about yourself or certain credentials that you have are true without necessarily like revealing all of the information. And so I think that that is going to be a really fruitful area, both for Web3 generally, but also is a place where zero knowledge is going to have just an enormous amount of impact.
Absolutely. It's clear that with a little help from zero knowledge, Web3 is going to change our lives in some pretty interesting ways. Stay tuned, because in part two, these experts will dive deeper into ZK and how Mina protocol is leading in ZK's development. Don't forget to like and subscribe to learn more about how zero knowledge is the key to privacy in Web3. You can learn more about zero knowledge and use cases using ZKPs in these videos. Thanks for watching.